Dear viewers of Kuwait Television, you can resume your program, Safe Harbor, directly after we update you with the latest concerning coronavirus from Ministry of Health. So please stay tuned in short time, and then you can resume watching your program. In the name of Almighty God, greetings to this conference number 82. Which is held by the Minister of Health today, Wednesday, the 25th of Shawwal, 1441 Hijri, corresponding to the 17th of June, 2020. This press conference is live on air directly from Minister of Health, Kuwait State, in order to update you with the latest development regarding the activities of COVID-19 caused agent of coronavirus SARS-CoV-2 in Kuwait State, the latest updates and developments in Kuwait State. Going directly to the field hospitals that were created in order to deal with this crisis and to receive patients infected by COVID-19 is one of them is the field hospital of the Solidarity Club, which is prepared through the engineering and the projects sector in the Ministry of Health. Greetings to the Undersecretary of Naham for such efforts and all the teams working with him in this great, important, vital department, actually exerting huge efforts since we start to deal with the events of this pandemic. Indeed, it's a source of a pleasure by the presence of Dr. Abdurrahman Al-Kandari, the manager of the field hospital of Solidarity Club. And this hospital and this club actually is in Farwaniya Governorate. And Dr. Abdurrahman, he is the one who runs the quarantine center also in Jalibishyukh and Farwaniya, to talk and to update us about the services. Dr. Abdurrahman is with us. After 1 minute, let's watch this video clip. This is the project of the field hospital. This is the Solidarity Club, which is where it was created within 3 days only. And it consists of a pharmacy, emergency, In the name of Almighty God, I would like to thank Abdullah for giving me that chance, and thanks for Kuwait Television for their efforts in order to cover the latest updates of this pandemic in Kuwait. We start to talk about that it is worth mentioning that all the field hospitals and quarantine centers in Kuwait Center works as an integrated health entity regarding this pandemic under the supervision of the Ministry of Health. That's why you will see, as a matter of fact, that the Minister of Health, after the Khitan and Farwaniya were under quarantine and curfew, so in order to provide the health security for these two areas, that's why there are indeed clinics working around the hour to receive the residents of these areas up till midnight also, and in case of emergency they can go to Farwaniya Hospital, and all those cases who need care inside the hospital. And the Ministry of Health noticed that it's quite important to create a field hospital in this vital area, which actually has a so much dense population. That's why the idea of creating the hospital at the Solidarity Club, and our engineering department exerted huge efforts in order to qualify this club and to change it into a field hospital in a short time. And thanks for all who did that. We started to receive patients on the 27th of May. Its idea is quite unique because it's supportive of the enteric diseases, especially as a kind of a supportive department. So we receive all those who are infected by coronavirus, who actually, after not severe cases, moderate to minor, in order to complete the treatment protocol and to be assessed, and then to be released to go back to their houses. It has, the capacity is 200 beds with respiratory and refreshment and refreshing units. Also, it is actually, we have a supportive life apparatus since the very beginning. And up till now, only one case, it was quite severe, and we sent it to Al Farwaniya Hospital. As a matter of fact, I would like to talk also about certain important items. It consists of a medical team. We have 15 doctors. Three of them are specialized in enteric diseases and respiratory, which is quite important. The rest of the doctors of different specialties. And so they got training courses in order to provide the best health services. And now they are quite professional and efficient to deal with coronavirus in our field hospital. And consequently, we follow the health protocol to treat corona. Also, our hospital contains a pharmacy with pharmacists, and all that is required to support the patients to complete their treatment. Also, Al Farwaniya Hospital supports us in case we need, for example, blood tests, certain lab tests, and on a daily basis, we send our test to them. And also, actually, the Farwaniya Directorate logistically help us. As I mentioned, that the aim of this hospital is to mitigate the burden and for more capacity of beds, and also to serve the residents of the area in a best way. And we are quite able to be an emergency unit in case it is needed, and according to the actually requirement of this period. And thanks God, everything is still under control in our field hospital. And thanks for all those who contributed to create this hospital and those who participated. And thanks a lot. Thank you, Dr. Abdurrahman. Dr. Abdurrahman Al-Kandari, the manager of the field hospital in the Solidarity Club in Farwaniya area and other field hospitals in Jalib Shuyukh area and the quarantine centers in these areas. I would like to thank all our medical teams. They are the champions, each one in his location. For those who are still working around the hour, let's say for more than 6 months, working continuously with all loyalty and devotion because of the sense of their responsibility to preserve all those who are living on this good land. Now, it is time to update you with the latest development and the manifestations, the announcement that we actually spotted within the last 24 hours. I would like to remind you that more important than the figures which we mention is what do they reflect of information, and the most important, how can we benefit of such data in order to change it into a preventive procedures to protect our families, our society as a whole. Let's start with those who got cured after they were infected by COVID-19 in Kuwait State. The total number is 28,896. This number, which is in front of you, actually constitutes 76.9% of all those who were confirmed infected in Kuwait. And this actually percentage is increasing if we compare it by yesterday, after we registered 676 new cured cases, 690 new cases. Those who ended their quarantine institutional period within the last 24 hours were 51 cases. 29 of them were Kuwaiti citizens and 22 non-Kuwaitis. As for the swabs regarding COVID-19, our efforts, the technical, the medicals, and the preventive for those who got in contact with others and is not sick, we did 2,885 swabs within the last 24 hours. By that, when we add this number, so all those who were took test, 343,027 since the outbreak of this pandemic. It is quite clear that when we talk about details of those who got infected by coronavirus and the follow-up of the local news, the international ones regarding this pandemic, especially about the precautionary procedures. So it is maybe beyond imagination that when he practices just simple steps, he will be able, by God's grace, to avoid major infections of this virus. One of these procedures, it is all that is related with personal hygiene or with your contact with others. As for personal hygiene, I would like to remind you that you have to keep on washing your hands by thoroughly by water and soap or by alcohol disinfections, and you have to keep on, because we can eliminate all viruses in your hands, even if you touched any type of surfaces or polluted materials by washing. And it's quite also important to avoid to contact your mouth, your nose, and your eyes. Through these three ports, the virus may affect you. And regarding the precautionary procedures regarding the others, keep the physical distancing minimum 1 meter between you and the others. And to practice what is we call the hygiene by covering your mouth and nose, especially when you cough or sneeze. By that, you will protect the droplets to be contact the others. So when we remind you of such recommendations and we repeat them permanently and on a daily basis, I would like to remind even ourselves, first of all, personally, always I try to apply these practices. And when we talk about certain practices, it is not because we want to blame others. It is only just for a public awareness, which we all need. And it's quite clear about how much it is quite important to abide by such constructions and which actually will be reflected positively on the stability of the current situation. Regarding the latest for those who got infected, it is confirmed new cases, 575 new infected cases within the last 24 hours. That took from them 317 were Kuwaiti citizens, which is equal to the percentage 55.13%. And the rest of the cases for non-Kuwaitis, which is 258 of a different nationalities, and that constitute a percentage of 44.87% of the total the last 24 hours infections. And then let's take the rate of the infected according to the health zones. Indeed, they all these zones actually exert huge efforts in order to monitor new infected cases, whether it is in the public hospitals, especially casualties, emergencies, and also to diagnose these cases where a complete full medical service is presented for them through our COVID teams, which is always available in all hospitals, and also through these medical health zones, we have 34 preventive health centers scattered around the whole country. Within the last 24 hours, we monitored 144 new cases in Al Ahmadi Health Zone, 139 in Al Jahra Health Zone, 128 in Farwaniya Health Zone, 96 in Hawali Health Zone. As for the capital, we monitored 68 new cases. As for the distribution of the infected according to the residential areas and the highest numbers within the last 24 hours, we noticed that in Al Qasr, we monitored 29 new cases, 28 in Salmiya area. This is in the last 24 hours, 27 in Jalibishuh area, 26 in Saad al-Abdallah area, 21 in Mahboula within the last 24 hours, and 19 in Al-Abdali. So now, the total number of those confirmed infected in Kuwait up till now, 37,533 cases. As for those required the intensive care unit, the total number 190 cases. As for the cases, death cases, after they were infected by coronavirus COV-2, where the virus and its implication was the main cause for their death, they were three new death cases, asking Almighty God mercy on their souls. So we will be able now to know the active cases which require medical attention, where the total number today 8,331. Up till now, by God's grace, everything is stable. If we still adhere of our personal commitment, consequently, the society commitment will result, will give a better results. Thank you very much. May God keep you safe.